Hello friend, in this video we are going to talk about the basic properties of E-plane, H-plane and magic key in microwave communication through practical explanation. So let's start. So here we are having our setup and block diagram. Our block diagram consists of microwave source, a device under test block and a power meter. Now let's analyze this each block. So this is our microwave source generator. It consists of just various kind of sub-blocks. So very first is of Clifton tube. Clifton tube is used to generate a microwave signal. Second block consists of an isolator. An isolator is used to isolate a signal from input port and output port. Third block is of variable attenuator. And the fourth block consists of the frequency meter, which is used to measure the frequency of generated microwave signal. So let's move towards our main block diagram, which consists of the second block having a device under test. Okay. So we have three devices under test: E plane, H plane, and a magic key. E plane. It is popularly known as a narrow plane of waveguide. It has its special characteristic that when input signal is fed to port P3, the signal is equally divided into port 1 and port 2 with 180 degree out of phase. Second, H-plane. It is popularly known as wide plane of waveguide. It has some special characteristics that when input signal is fed to port 3, the signal is equally divided into port 1 and port 2 with same phase. And third is the magic key. It is combination of E-plane and H-plane. Arm 3 forms an H-plane T with arms 1 and 2. Arm 4 forms E-plane T with arms 1 and 2. Arm 1 and 2 sometimes called as an collinear plane because they lies in same plane. Port 3 is also called as sum port or P port, and port 4 is called as a difference port. In this experiment, our power requirement is fulfilled by a Clifton power supply, which consists of various kind of different knobs, but here we are going to use mainly 4 knobs. First knob is of a modulation, so it is already set to a clock continuous wave knob, because in this experiment we are required a continuous wave. Second, a meter select knob, which is having a 3 mode, that is voltage mode, current mode and regular voltage mode. The third knob is of beam voltage, which should be at its minimum position initially. And the fourth knob is of a regular voltage knob, which should be a maximum initially. So let's start our So now let's move toward a different part, that is a match termination part. A match termination is used to measure an output power, and it is having the attenuation of 20 dB. And the output power is, as we know that a current is constant throughout our experiment, so we have to calculate the power. We are required to measure the voltage. So we'll require a one multimeter. Our experimentation friends, here we have set our repeller voltage to -180. So at this repeller voltage we are getting the maximum power at an output port, that is we are getting the voltage in 200 volt. So if our voltage is maximum, then it means our power is also maximum, as the current is constant. So now let's see how. Now in this case we have match terminated our output. Now let's see in the different case that after applying E plane and H plane and magic T, what the changes are and how does actually the microwave signal transfer.
As we have connected E plane, now you can observe that how we have connected E plane, that one terminal is match terminated, that is port 2, and we have given the input from port 3, and we have taken the output from port 1, and see what kinds of reading we are getting. That is, we are getting near about 124 approximately. Let's proceed our discussion on E-plane. As we can see that how we have made our connection. We have taken the input at port 3 and we have match terminated the port 1 and we have taken the output from port 2, as you can observe. Now see what kind of readings we are getting. We are getting near about 127 millivolt. Now let's now friend, we have connected H plane. As you can observe that we have given a input at port 3 and we have taken the output from port 2 and we have match terminated the port 1 and see what kind of reading we are getting. As you can observe that we are getting near about 89-90 millivolt on H plane. As you can observe that we have given the input at port 3 and we have taken the output from port 1 and we have match terminated the port 2, and now let us see what kind of reading we are getting. We are getting near about same reading, that is near about 100. Now as let's proceed our discussion on Magic Tea. As you can see that we have taken the output from port 2 and we have taken the input from port 3 and all remaining other ports are match terminated, and see what kind of reading we are getting. As you can observe that we are getting the reading approximately equal to 127 millivolt. Friend, let's proceed our discussion on Magic Tea. As you can observe that we have taken the output from port 1 and we have given an input from port 3, and as you can observe that what kind of reading we are getting. Let's see. So we are getting the reading approximately equal to 127 or 120, near approximately 120. Let's proceed our discussion on Magic Tea. As you can see that we have taken the output from port 4 and we have given the input at port 3, and remaining both the collinear ports we have match terminated. As you can observe that we are getting a null reading at multimeter, which means that we are getting a 0 millivolt. This is because port 4 act as a difference port. And so let's go at final stage of our Magic Tea. As you can observe that we have given an input at port 4 and we have taken the output from port 1, and remaining all the other ports are match terminated. So we can see that what kind of reading we are getting. So we are getting approximately near about 120 to 130 millivolt. Let's continue our discussion on Magic Tea. As you can observe that we have taken the output from port 2 and we have given input at port 4, and all the other remaining ports are match terminated, and we can see that what kind of reading we are getting. As you can observe that we are getting near about approximately 120 to 130 millivolt of reading. So friend, let's take a final reading of our experiment. As you can observe that we have given the input at port 4 and we are now taking the output from port 3, and as one can observe that we are getting a null output at multimeter, that is we are getting 0 volt. So one can conclude that port 3 is now acting as a difference port.